Hello everyone. Soon you all are having your exam. So let's revise our second chapter that we have already learned. In this chapter, we have learned about pure substances. What is a pure substance? A substance is said to be pure if it is made up of only one kind of molecules or particles. Pure substances normally cannot be separated by simple physical method, and they are largely classified as elements and compounds. An element consists of only one type of particles, which can be atoms or molecules. If we take example of gold metal, it consists of atoms, and all the atoms, they have same chemical structure. Gold metal is made up of same kind of atoms, so it is element and it is pure. If we take example of water, it is a compound. It is made up of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen. These two elements, they leave their own property and they make water. And this water, it has different property from the elements. Hydrogen is a good fuel. Oxygen, that we know, it is supporter of combustion. But water is not a supporter of combustion. Here, hydrogen and oxygen, they have left their own property and they have made a substance which has totally new property. So all the compounds, they are also known as pure substance, because elements, they combine in fixed ratio. They combine chemically. We cannot separate them out by any physical method. So compound is also included as a pure substance. Now another term. If a substance is not pure, then we call it as a mixture. What is a mixture? It is a material which contains two or more different kind of particle, means atoms or molecules are different, which do not react chemically but are physically mixed together in any proportion. Please note, mixture do not have a fixed composition. Particles, they are mixed together in any proportion, while in compound, they are present in a fixed proportion. Mixture, they are of two types, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture, in which all the components are uniformly mixed. We cannot see a boundary. We can take example of sugar dissolved in water. Mixture of sugar and water is a good example of homogeneous mixture, in that we cannot see any boundary of solute and solvent. We cannot see the solute particle. While the opposite of this homogeneous is heterogeneous mixture, in that components are not thoroughly mixed. We can see a boundary, and we can take example of sand and water, a mixture of sand and water in which we can see the sand particles. If we mix them, they do not get mixed. We can see a clear boundary of water and sand particles. So that is example of heterogeneous mixture. Now in homogeneous mixture, we have solution, or we can call it true solution. Let's see what are the properties of true solution. True solution, it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances like salt water, sugar solution, soda water, lemon water. These are good example of solution. In solution, we cannot see the solute particle with our naked eye because size of particle is very, very small. Solution, they never scatter beam of light, or we can say they do not show Tyndall effect, because size of particle is of nanometer. 1 nanometer means 10 to power minus 9 meter. Solution have two components, solute and solvent. Solute means what? The component of solution that is dissolved in the solvent and which is present in less quantity, it is solute. And the component which is present in larger amount in which solute dissolves is called a solvent. Based on type of solvent, solution are of two type, aqueous solution, non-aqueous solution. Aqueous solution in which water is present as a solvent. If we take water as a solvent and we dissolve anything in water, then the solution is aqueous. And if water is not present as a solvent, other than water, if we use alcohol, ether, then it is called non-aqueous solution. So we have two types, aqueous and non-aqueous. Aqueous means presence of water, while non-aqueous means other than water, any other solvent is present. Solution of NaCl in water, it is called aqueous solution, while tincture of iodine, in which iodine is dissolved in alcohol, so it is called non-aqueous solution. When we dissolve solute in a solution, then its amount varies. Depending on the amount of solute present in a solution, we have three types of solution: saturated solution, unsaturated solution, and supersaturated solution. First of all, if we cannot add more amount of solute in a solution, means in a solution when no more amount of solute can be dissolved, it is called saturated solution. And this saturation level, it depends on temperature of the solution. With temperature, if we increase the temperature, solubility increases and we can add more amount of solute in a saturated solution. Please note, temperature plays important role. If we increase the temperature, we can increase the solubility of a substance. We can increase its saturation level. Opposite of that, if we decrease the temperature, solubility decreases. And if we can add more amount of solute in a solution, then the solution, it is called unsaturated solution. Other than saturated and unsaturated, we have one more type, supersaturated solution. What's that? If we increase the temperature of saturated solution, if we dissolve more amount of solute in a saturated solution by increasing temperature, then solution become supersaturated solution. Supersaturated means amount of solute is more than its saturation point. If we dissolve more amount of solute in a saturation solution, then it becomes supersaturated solution. And sometime in the supersaturated solution, if we decrease the temperature, then particles of solute, they remain undissolved at the bottom. In this session, we have revised many things about solution. In our next session, we will revise colloidal solution and suspension. And we will see how we can calculate concentration and solubility of a given substance.